बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामु अलैकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहू। हाउ आर यू सेकंड ईयर स्टूडेंट्स? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन। सेकंड ईयर स्टूडेंट्स, यस्टरडे इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डन हाफ टॉपिक ऑफ फोर्स ऑन अ मूविंग चार्ज इन अ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड। Yesterday we have calculated force on the conductor and its value N A Q B L cross B. Yesterday we have calculated and we have discussed the diagram, this one, in complete detail. Just like the volume of this is a wire segment and its volume is represented by A L. A is area and L is the length of this wire segment, and total number of charge carriers represented by N. And they are multiplied by AL, so total number of charges NAL. And we have discussed about these charges. If Q is a charge carrier, then total number of charges represented by NALQ. And in this way, the time taken by one charge to from one side towards the other side, we have calculated here by using formula S is equal to V delta T, and then this S, this distance is replaced by the length L, as this total distance is equal to the length of this wide segment. So we have formula L is equal to V delta T, and after that we have calculated delta T time, that is L over V. And we have defined current yesterday, I is equal to delta Q over T, this one, and we have put the value of delta Q and delta T. Value of delta Q is NALQ and delta T is L over V. Finally, calculated value of current is I is equal to NAQV. So the force on the conductor having length L is IL cross B. Putting the value of I, FL is equal to force exerted on the conductor having length L is NAQV L cross B. Yesterday we have done this topic till this equation, that is equation number 14.7. So today we will continue the rest of the part of this topic. Second year, before understanding the equational part, mathematical part of your book, tell me what is unit vector and what unit vector is equal to. Revise this concept of unit vector, you have learnt it in first year. Suppose L is unit vector and V is also unit vector, and unit vector is equal to vector over vector's magnitude. So we can write L unit vector in place of this one, L vector over vector's magnitude, okay? While on other side, this V is a unit vector and it can be written as V vector over vector's magnitude, okay? So we can write as V vector over vector's magnitude, vector's speed v, v magnitude of v multiplied by L vector. This is vector. In numerator these are vector, while in denominator there are magnitude of the same quantity, okay? L is length of the vector, while this L in denominator magnitude of the same vector quantity. So now cross multiplication, magnitude of speed multiplied by length vector, and magnitude of length multiplied by V vector. So I have written here V magnitude L vector, L magnitude V vector. So as we know, we have learned the formula, force exerted on the conductor having length L is written as NAQL, now V cross B, okay? L V cross B. VL is, yesterday we have learned VL in last formula. You can see here in your book, this one, VL. V is magnitude of speed V, while L is vector. So now VL is replaced by LV. Okay, L is now magnitude and V is vector in current situation, just like here. FL NAQL V cross B, FL is equal to NAQL V cross B. So now we know that the force, it is written as FL over NAL from the last formula, that is this one, FL over NAL. NAL, take these quantities from here, NAL. N is number of charges, A is area of the conductor, L is the length of the conductor, right? Conductor is now here Y segment. FL over NAL, and remaining one is QV cross B. NAL you have taken from this side in denominator of FL. So you can see here FL over NAL is equal to F. This is force. This remaining portion QV cross B, this is the force experienced by the charge, whether the charge is a proton or charge is a electron. So that's why we can write it here. This Q is charge in case of proton, F is equal to plus E V cross B, while in case of electron, this force is minus E V cross B. So I am repeating again. The rest of the term, rather than this one, is denoted by F, and F is equal to Q V cross B. If there is electron, then we will write minus E V cross B, and if there is proton, then we will write plus E V cross B. This is the force experienced by that charge. Dear students, I have explained this complete topic in simple, in short and easy wording. Now read these steps yourself. You can easily understand these steps easily. So now, in case of electron, you can write F is equal to minus E V cross B. And in case of proton, F is equal to plus E V cross B. Note that in case of proton or positive charges, the direction of the force is given by the direction of the vector V cross B. This one is V and this one is B, right? Rotate V to coincide with B, rotate it to coincide with B through the smaller angle of rotation, and curl the fingers of right hand in the direction of rotation in this way, in the direction of rotation. The thumb will point in the direction of the force. This illustrated in figure 14.9, in this figure, in which the proton, this is proton, enters into the magnetic field. This one is magnetic field. So when it enters into the magnetic field, it will experience a force in upper direction. So it is inserting inward, while when it inserts in the presence of magnetic field, it will experience a force in upper direction. So that's why it takes turn in upper direction. While reverse case happens with negative charge. If electron enters in a magnetic field, then it will enter, and after entering it will experience a force, and this force exerts the charges in downward direction. Proton in upper direction and electron in downward direction. So this is written, this complete explanation is written here. This is important conceptual question. What is the effect of force experienced by electron and proton when they are entered in the same magnetic field? Both are directed in opposite direction, proton in upper while electron in downward direction, as both have opposite charges. One thing more is that cross product shows sine theta. So F is equal to EVB sine theta. So value of force is maximum when theta is 90 degree, when the angle between V and B is 90 degree, both are perpendicular to each other. While force experienced by the charge is minimum when the angle between V and B is 0 degree. Okay, this complete explanation is written on next page. Dear students, as we have discussed, when angle theta is 0, then it is a maximum, the force is maximum when theta is equal to 90 degree between two quantities V and B. Okay, and it is 0 when theta is equal to 0 degree. A charged particle projected in the direction of field experiences no force when theta is equal to 0 degree between them. Second year, now we have completed topic 14.5, that is very important long question, within two lectures. So listen these two lectures attentively and learn the topic and do at least one time written practice after learning, so that it will be easily, all concept will be easily clear to you. पिया मानिला, अस्सलाम वालेकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहू।